you an update today on how I've been doing, and I also wanted to talk about a topic that's really become super, I guess, in the forefront for me right now, and I wanted to share my views on it. So, first of all, I looked up the word journey in the dictionary, and the definition was actually more simple than I thought it would be. It just said the act or instance of traveling from one place to another. And so I think of my journey as being one place was unhealthy, type 2 diabetic, 220 pounds, osteopenia, unable to move or do any kind of exercise. And the end of my journey, I see as being at my normal body weight, my healthy body weight, perhaps around 125 pounds. And being able to pretty much do anything physically that I desire to do. So I'm not there yet, and I'm on the journey. I'm on the path toward that. But there are some things that I've learned since the beginning of my journey that I think have really helped me to stay on the path and also to keep moving along it versus stopping. And the times that I stalled or stopped, I'm analyzing those things and trying to figure out why that is. One thing that really helped me on my journey is to change the food that I was eating. That was probably the greatest accelerator to my journey of anything. So before, I used to eat the standard American diet. I ate a lot of fast food. I ate a lot of junk food. I used a lot of canned goods, cream of mushroom soup, and things like that, putting those into my meals. And my diet in general was super unhealthy. So changing the food by eating whole plant-based foods, fruits, vegetables, whole grains, beans, nuts, seeds, and avocado, with occasional vegan treats here and there, I was able to drop 50 pounds and really change the course of my health from the perspective of my diabetes and osteopenia, because losing that weight and changing the food actually helped me get off medications and to really, I guess, live for the first time in my life. So changing the food, number one, gotta do it. Once you change the food, you're on that path, you're accelerated and moving quickly. And that is what I recommend you focus on first. The second thing is changing your movement level. So when I started the journey, I really couldn't move at all. I couldn't walk very far. I certainly couldn't walk up steps well. I couldn't run or didn't feel that I could do any of those things. And it's true, when you're heavier, those things are hard to do. When your heart is not in good shape, those things are hard to do. So as I moved along the journey path, I realized that I was more and more able to try different types of movement, and I actually could do them. So, changing your movement level is super important on the journey. It doesn't mean that you have to be a runner, it doesn't mean that you have to be a professional cyclist. It just means that you need to move your body every single day as much as you can. So if you have the opportunity to park your car further and walk a little more into the store, do it. If you have the opportunity to take the stairs instead of taking the elevator, do it. So those are the things that will change your movement level. The third thing I want to talk about, which has been the greatest stumbling block in my journey, is changing my habits. You know, you can change the food. If you have a plate of food that is not healthy, and then you just exchange that plate of food to lower calorie dense, healthy plant foods, you're gonna lose weight. That's just gonna happen. But that doesn't change some of the deep-seated habits that you formed through the years. And I had lots of bad habits, and some of them, thankfully, along this journey, they naturally went away, which is fantastic. Like, for example, I don't eat fast food anymore. The reason I don't eat fast food anymore, I say anymore, I mean, I eat a Chipotle once in a while and things like that, but I don't eat, obviously, Chick-fil-A and things like that. I don't eat that stuff anymore. And obviously, not eating those things contributed to a benefit in my journey because those things were super fattening, they were super unhealthy. And so just not being able to eat chicken anymore when you choose to eat plant-based, that helped. I'm not over at Chick-fil-A, having one of those fried chicken sandwiches, a big thing of fries, and a shake, because I can't eat any of those things anymore because I've chosen the plant-based lifestyle. So just naturally, some of those old behaviors and habits went away when I decided to become plant-based. But there are some habits that did not go away for me when I became plant-based, and they were things like snacking in between my meals. I could still snack plant-based in between my meals. And what I was finding is that I was actually ingesting a lot of extra calories in between my meals that I really didn't need. I wasn't physically hungry. I was just either bored or just saw something that looked good to me, or just the habit of eating in between meals, which is something that I always did. I pretty much grazed all day when I was 220 pounds. The second thing is that I have a habit of mindlessly eating when I am not really focused on the food. So I might be typing on Facebook to people, or I might be reading a book, or I might be talking to my husband, but I'm eating and not really thinking about the food that I'm eating. So there's a great chance that when you're mindlessly eating, you can be eating more than your body actually needs. And that kind of leads me into the eating too much, because that was the greatest, I think the greatest issue with my plateau is that once I got down 50 pounds, I was still eating the same amount of food that I ate prior. And so that just basically caused me to stall because I was still eating too many calories and I wasn't losing any additional weight. So, right now in my journey, I'm focused on habit change. I want to change some of the ways that I've done things before. And at first, habit change is hard. Sometimes you have to white knuckle it. You have to really say no with a persistence on things that you know aren't good for you. For example, the eating in between meals. When I eat a good healthy meal at my meal number one, which is around 11 o'clock in the morning, I really don't need to eat again until 5. When I get close to 5, I get pretty darn hungry. But physically, our bodies don't need that food. We don't need any more food for, anywhere from 4 to 6 hours. And there's even evidence to show that you don't even need food for longer than that, obviously, because I do 16-8 intermittent fasting. And so I don't eat for 16 to 18 hours every single day, and my body is just fine. In fact, it's better. So I'm working right now specifically on not eating in between meals. And if I am, I said before in my last video that if I eat in between meals, it's going to be something really low calorie dense, like some kind of raw vegetable. But really, I don't even want to do that. I don't want to have that habit of eating anything in between my meals. So I'm really working on just not having anything in between the two meals at all. So that's the big one. The second one is pushing away things at my meal time that are distracting. So I'm actually focused on eating my food and then getting back to those things, like not having the laptop open, not having the phone right next to me while I'm eating, and really focusing on enjoying my food, eating slowly, and just creating that new habit of not connecting that with doing other things. So those are the two things that I'm working on right now. There's a lot more habits that I could be improving, but I wanted to just start with two. And I'm gonna let you guys know how that's going. I'm doing really well right now, but I'm gonna keep you abreast of that. Also, I wanted to tell you, and I posted this in my Mrs. Plant Facebook page, is that in the month of January, I lost 8 pounds doing intermittent fasting and eating Lean and Clean by High Carb Hannah. I was eating a lot of the recipes that are in her ebook, as well as recipes of my own and others that I know of that follow that same idea of eating Lean and Clean with a minimal amount of salt. And then in February, I did something that I knew was going to be a problem, but I'm glad that I did it because you always learn from things that you do, which is that I ate out a lot in February. For some reason, we had people invite us to do things, or we went out because we just last minute didn't have anything planned. And I just planned poorly in February in general. I didn't write down what we were going to have for dinner every single night. Maybe Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday I knew what we were having, and then it was like the rest of the week we just kind of winged it, and it was bad. So in the month of February, which is a short month, but still, I only lost 1 pound. But I did maintain the 8 pound loss, so I had a total of 9 pounds. So that was on the 28th of February that I did that weight. I weighed myself. And then starting March, I decided I'm going to make some changes with my habits. And so March 1st was Tuesday. So I weighed myself on Tuesday and I weighed myself this morning, and I've already lost. Today is Thursday. So I've already lost in 3 days, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, another pound. Now that's only in a few days. And that is by tracking my food, planning ahead, knowing what I'm going to eat every day. So just kind of deciding what is going to be my meal one and what's going to be my meal two, and just throwing that into Chronometer and just making sure that it fits between my caloric range, which is between 1200 and 1300 calories a day. Remember, I'm only 5'2", so I'm small. And I also struggle with other conditions that have made it difficult for me to lose weight. I have insulin resistance. I'm type 2 diabetic. I am 52 years old. I've had a hysterectomy, so hormonally, I have different issues. And so my metabolism apparently can't handle more than that and still lose weight. But I'm eating really good, healthy, filling, low calorie dense foods. I have not felt hungry. I felt fantastic. I've been doing my walking 5 days a week, and I'm building some really good healthy habits. So I'm excited that now I'm down 10 pounds since the beginning of the year. That's huge for me. And my next goal is to lose maybe another 5 pounds before the beginning of April. So in total, sorry, including the 1 pound that I lost this week. So 5 pounds for this month is my goal. I think that's very doable if I, you know, just continue to change my bad habits into good ones and continue to focus on eating and not doing other things at the same time, and not eating in between meals, and keeping my movement level where I have it right now, which I think is perfect. I think that I can meet those goals. So anyway, I just wanted to share with you the three things that I think really help to lose weight and to change your physical and health conditions. Like I said, I'm working on number three right now, which is changing habits. So I'll be back soon to give you guys an update. Have a great day.